Welcome to all my students. Today we will continue to study about social stratification. In the previous session, we had learnt about social inequality, education, gender, profession, income, opportunities, and others. Social stratification. These are the two topics we had completed in the previous session. In today's session, we will learn about untouchability, a social problem, legal steps to eradicate untouchability. So before learning about untouchability, what we had learned in the previous session, let me recollect. In the previous session, we had learned about social inequality, where social inequality is based on gender, caste, profession, class, and race. Social inequality are income sources, education sources, and professional opportunities. And we also learned in that is because unequal access to opportunities, due to that social inequality exists in the society. And next one, we learned about education and inequality. In education and inequality, we learned about nearly 8 articles in that. Article 39, providing social justice and people welfare is a duty of the state government. Article 21A, free and compulsory education to all children between 6 and 14 years is a fundamental right of the children. Article 45 says all children under 14 years should be provided with free and compulsory education. Article 19 says that right to speak and right to express. And next we learned about Article 29, which provides for the protection of cultural rights of the minorities. And Article 31 provides for the establishment of minority education institution. Article 46 expresses that it is a duty of the government to support the education interest of scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. So these are the articles what we had read in the education and inequality. Then we learned about gender inequality, where they have clearly mentioned about the body mass index. We can see that in the Arabian women it is 16.2%, whereas in the rural women it is 24.3%. And we have seen between the month of 6 and 56 months of children, we have seen they are suffering with severe anemia. And the pregnant women are also suffering with anemia. The percentage is 45.2%. After that, we learn what is social stratification. The human society has continued the practice of classifying people as superior, inferior, and upper and lower, assigning differential roles and status. This method of dividing people into different strata and then assigning different roles and status in the society is called as social stratification. After learning the definition of social stratification, we learned about the feature of social stratification. In the 4 points we have learned, first one was social stratification is social in nature. Second one, social stratification is universal. Third one, social stratification is ancient. And the last one we learned, social stratification exists in different ways. So these are the topic which we learned in the previous session. Now we will learn about untouchability. In the beginning, the Varna system was present in the Indian society. It is believed that it started during Vedic period. 4 Varna system is a system of social division. It is said that it is based on karma theory. So we have to know the root cause of untouchability. From where did this untouchability came into the society? So first we will start from the Vedic period. If you see, from the Vedic period, we had adopted Varna system. The meaning of Varna system is caste system. We have four Varna system, and these are the social division, based on the social division. And this is based on the karma theory. Let me learn which are those four Varna system. First one, Brahmana. Who? A person who study, teaching, participation in yajnas. These are the work of Brahmana. Kshatriya, who play a very important role in political administrations. And the next one, Vaishya, business. They were indulgent business activities. Shudra, manual labors. So the four Varna systems were Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. Brahmana, if you see, their main work was to teach, to study, participate in yajnas. So we, in a generally, we call them as a priest. Kshatriyas, political administration, who were the rulers. Vaishyas were business people. Shudras were manual laborers. The fifth group, which were considered as untouchables, were never considered as a human. So remember, I have told you in Varna system, we have only four Varna system. And one more group was there, that is the fifth group, whom we did not consider as a human itself. The practice of untouchability has begun in Varna system. The issue of untouchables and untouchables is related to profane and sacred idea based on inequality in socio-economic area of life. So here you can see that the fifth group we have not mentioned in the Vedic system, in the Vedic period itself. So we did not consider them as a human, and there has always been a differentiate between touchables and untouchables, and moreover, these untouchables were not considered as a human itself, and always they were deprived from socio-economic activities. Now this picture will help you to remember about the Varna system. How many Varna systems are there, children? Four Varna systems are there. Which is the first one? Brahmana. Second one, Kshatriya. Third one, Vaishya. Fourth one, Shudra. So what is the work of a Brahmana? Study and participating in yajnas. Kshatriyas, political administration. Vaishya, business activities. And Shudra, manual labors. The British government, through its Indian Government Act in 1935, they classified untouchables and tribal people as scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. Remember, this act is important. In Indian Government Act 1935, which was introduced by the British government, according to that act, they classified the untouchables and the tribal people as scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. The most important, the Ambedkar said, an analyzing of why a group of people stayed outside the village, whether they came from outside or were pushed outside, provide an answer to the birth and practice of untouchability, says Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. And Gandhiji, according to Gandhiji, untouchability is a heinous expression of caste system. Heinous means hatred. Is that clear? So these are the quotation which was said by Ambedkar and Gandhiji regarding untouchabilities. Now, we will see what are the problems faced by untouchability. So, in Manusmriti, they have clearly mentioned the problem which was undergoing by the untouchables. Anyone who touches the untouchables had to undergo purification many times. According to Manusmriti, by mistake, the touchables touches the untouchable, they have to undergo purification many times. That was clearly mentioned in Manusmriti. One more. As per the Vyagarapada Smriti, they have clearly mentioned the touchables have to maintain distance from the untouchables. So the distance also is clearly mentioned. How much distance should be maintained between the untouchables and touchables? In Malabar, untouchables were not allowed to wear footwear and they were not allowed to use well, tank, cemetery used by the touchables. See the condition of untouchables, how they were treated in Malabar. Untouchables used to prepare footwear, but they were not allowed to use it. And the next one is, they were not allowed to touch well, tank, cemeteries used by the untouchables. The next you can see, according to B. Kupaswami, he has clearly mentioned the untouchables were doing 50 types of work. In that, the work was to carry night soil, dead animals. For this purpose only, untouchables were used. And this was said by B. Kupaswami. He clearly mentioned that untouchables were allowed to carry night soil, that is human waste. They were allowed to use to carry the human waste, dead animals, and like this, other 50 jobs were given to the untouchables. This was a condition of untouchables. Previous slide we saw in Manusmriti how the untouchables were treated by touchables. By mistake, untouchables touches the touchables. They have to undergo the purification. Who has to undergo? Touchables have to go purification for several times. In Vyagarapada Smriti, we also learn that how the untouchables were treated. The distance between the touchables and untouchables clearly mentioned. The distance of a cow tail has to be maintained between the touchables and untouchables. And in Malabar, we saw how these untouchables were treated. They were not allowed to wear footwear. They were not allowed to touch wells, tank, and they did not have their own cemetery. And these were the problem the untouchables were facing in Malabar. With that, clearly mentioned by B. Kupaswami, 50 jobs were given for the untouchables. In that, if you see, they were allowed to carry night soils, dead animals. These sort of work only was given for the untouchables. So these are the problem was faced by the untouchables. By seeing this picture, you could have clearly analyzed and I'm talking about a problem in Malabar where untouchables were not allowed to use this well. Touchables can use it, but untouchables were not allowed to use the well which was used by touchables. And next you can see that here where the untouchable don't have their own cemetery. They were only allowed to carry the dead animals. This was a condition of the people in Malabar. And they were not even allowed to build the houses above one store in a height. And they were not allowed to cemetery their dead. Untouchables were kept out of education for many centuries. They were not supposed to listen Veda recitation nor recite them also. They were barred from learning Sanskrit. In a democracy, individuals have right to decide on their personal issues. All should have the skill to think logically and act. Hence, B.R. Ambedkar fought hard to make people realize the importance of education. In the previous two slides, I have explained about the problem of untouchables. One more problem untouchables were facing, that was they were deprived of education. They had no right of education. Not only that, they were not allowed to listen Vedas, nor they were allowed to recite the Veda, and they were barred from learning Sanskrit language. This was a condition of untouchables in education field. So first thing is, they were not given education right. With that, they were not allowed to recite Vedas, and they were not allowed to listen what they recited, the Veda. And with that, they were barred from learning Sanskrit language. This was a condition of untouchables. B.R. Ambedkar, who came forward and started fighting for the untouchables. And he clearly mentioned, in a democratic country, every individual have a right to decide their personal issues. All should have a skill to think logically and act. And this skill can develop only when they are given importance to education. So hence, B.R. Ambedkar fought hard to make people realize the importance of education. Education provides an entry into the issue of demanding social justice, that is, social equality. Having realized the importance of education in individual life, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar argued in favor of education as public property. It is not a private property, it belongs to everyone. So he mentioned it as education as public property due to such revolutionary ideas and thoughts. So Ambedkar, he started fighting for the untouchables. And he knew that if he has to get rid of social inequality, he has to give importance to education. And through education, the untouchables can demand about social justice. And he clearly mentioned that education as a public property, not as a private property. So he mentions that every individual in the society has a right for education. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar could come up with more provisions and directives in draft version of the Constitution of India. He is rightly called as a chief architect of Indian Constitution. So in Indian Constitution, we have clearly given importance for right to education. All that article in the previous session have clearly mentioned, and this was done with the help of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, who is the chief architect of Indian Constitution. Observe this picture, children. He is B.R. Ambedkar, who is the chief architect of Indian Constitution, who fought for the untouchables. He always tried to uplift the untouchables by giving them importance for education. Traditionally, the untouchables were not allowed to own any property and were only expected to serve their master. The denial of such right in Dharma Shastra was mentioned clearly. In traditionally political system, untouchables were not allowed to participate. So as I mentioned in the beginning, what are the problems faced by the untouchables? And next I explained, the next problem was education. Now Two more rights were deprived for them was having their own property. Untouchables were not allowed to have their own property. And this was clearly mentioned in Dharma Shastra. So untouchables did not have their own property. With that, one more they were deprived. That is political system. They were not allowed for any political right. So untouchables were deprived of education, property and political right. They were not allowed to participate in the political system. They were kept away from all these rights due to the effort of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. The untouchables could get opportunity in politics and administrative areas. After the independence, reservation was brought to effect in electoral constituency for scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. The Indian constitution provides a commitment for the eradication of untouchability, which itself is unique in world history. So here you can clearly understand that the most important person who fought for untouchables was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He tried his best and he was successful in giving an opportunity for untouchables in the field of politics as well as administrative areas. After independence, he also saw that their names were enrolled in electoral constituency for scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. So Indian constitution played a very important role in eradication of untouchability, and which itself is a unique in world history. So these are the article and the act which was implemented to eradicate untouchability in our country. Untouchability as a social problem has still remained in spite of effort from the leaders like Jyotiba Phule, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and many others. It has remained alive in Indian society. Hence, many legal provisions have been brought to eradicate untouchability. First one, Article 17. The Indian Constitution prohibits untouchability. The Government of India has implemented Untouchability Crime Act in 1955. Civil Rights Protection Act was implemented in 1976 with necessary changes to the Act of 1955. So first remember, Jyotiba Phule, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and many other leaders fought against the untouchability. And due to that, many legal provisions were brought to overcome or to eradicate untouchability. Article 17, that is prohibit over untouchability. And Act 1955, that is Untouchability Crime Act in 1955. 1976 Act was implemented, and that act was Civil Right Protection Act was implemented in 1976, and they made changes, unnecessary changes in the Act of 1955. According to the Civil Right Protection Act, which was implemented in the year 1976 with a necessary change to the Act of 1955. According to this act, practicing untouchability is a crime. Anyone who is practicing untouchability will be punished severely. Universal right to vote, participate in election has been provided. Moreover, reservation has been given in the field of education and employment for scheduled caste and scheduled tribe along with backward classes. So according to the Civil Right Protection Act, which was implemented in the year 1976, and they had made some changes in the Act of 1955. According to that, if anyone practice untouchability, will considered as a crime. And moreover, untouchables were given right to vote, and they were also given right to participate in the election. And moreover, reservation was being implemented in the field of education, employment, mainly for scheduled castes, scheduled tribe, along with backward classes. So remember, Civil Rights Act, which was implemented in 1976, in that you have to remember, first point is untouchability is considered as a crime. Second one is they were given universal right to vote. And third one is participate in election. And fourth one was reservation has been given in the field of education one. The other one is employment. And mainly for whom, if you see, it is for the scheduled caste and scheduled tribe along with the backward classes. And next act is Act of 1989. Some specific responsibility for the government in eradication of untouchability. That means government was given certain responsibility, specific responsibility they were given to see that in their state, they should see that they can eradicate untouchability. In their state, untouchability should not exist and nobody should practice untouchability. It is the duty of the state government to eradicate untouchability. This was a specific responsibility was given for the government under the Act of 1989. Next, assignment. The first question, state the function performed by the Varna system. Here, you have to mention from when did the Varna system start. And all of you remember, it has started from the Vedic period. And there are four Varna system. It is based on karma theory. And you have to mention about Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudras. Brahmana, study, teaching, participating in yajnas. Kshatriyas, political administration. Vaishya, business. And the last one is Shudras, manual labors. So these are the points what you have to write in the first question. The next one is, what are the constitutional and legal measures taken to remove untouchability? So remember, here you have to mention two leaders' name, that is Jyotiba Phule, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, and many other leaders played an important role in eradicating untouchability. And with their effort only, many legal measures were taken to remove untouchability. Now you have to explain about Article 17, and then you have to explain about the Act of 1955, 1976. Then you have to mention about the Act of 1989. So these are the things you have to remember to mention in the last. So now I will just tell you once again, starting from Article 17, you have to write in the second question. Article 17, you will mention that Indian Constitution prohibits untouchability. Then when you are mentioning about Article 55, that is Act 55, the Government of India has implemented Untouchability Crime Act in 1955. Third point will be Civil Rights Protection Act was implemented in 1976 with necessary changes to Act of 1955. And in the Act of 1976, what provisions were given for untouchability has to be explained. First one is, practice of untouchability is a crime. Second point, universal right to vote and participate in election. Third point, reservation has been given in the field of education and employment for scheduled caste and scheduled tribes along with backward class. And the next one is, Act of 1989 has given some specific responsibility for the government in eradicating of untouchability. So these are the points what you have to write in what are the constitutional and legal measure taken to remove untouchability. Remember children, this is an important question, and this question every year it is repeated in the essay 2, and this is a confirmed question which you get it in your essay 2. So this question has to be written without seeing. First you will learn this and then write without seeing. Mainly the second question, what are the constitutional and legal measure taken to remove untouchability? So Article 17 you will write, Act 1955, Act 1976 and Act 1989. So these are the points you have to write. I'm repeating it twice because this is a very important question which is often repeated in your final exam. So you will write this question with answer without seeing. First read it, then you will write it. Is that clear, children? Any other doubt if you have, you can call me. I will clarify your doubt. Thank you, children.